Hello students, welcome to Saurav sir's classes. Today we are going to solve CAT 2017 question paper slot 2. So let us begin with our question paper. So now we are going to solve the quantitative ability section and we will solve the other topics further. So let's begin with our first sum, that is question number 67. So it says the numbers 1, 2, 3 and dot 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 till 9 are arranged in a 3 cross 3 square grid in such a way that each number occurs only once and the entries along each column, each row and each of the two diagonals add up the same value. So here we have a 3 cross 3 square grid in which we need to arrange numbers from 1 to 9, that are 9 numbers, and we have a 9 empty columns in a 3 cross 3 square grid. So each number will obviously occur only once, and we have a condition here that the entries along each column, each row and each of the two diagonals add up the same value. So we need to maintain this condition. So now let's draw a 3 cross 3 square grid. So this is our border of the grid. Now we need to divide this in 3 cross 3 sections. So here we have our 3 columns and here we have our 3 rows. So this is our 3 cross 3 square grid, and it is said that the entries along each column, each row and each of the two diagonals add up the same value. So as we know that sum of this column, sum of this column, sum of this column is equal to sum of this row, sum of this row, sum of this row, and is also equal to sum of this diagonal and also equal to sum of these diagonals. So basically each 3 number package has the same value after summing them up. So let's check what is said here. If the top left of the and the top right entries of the grid are 6 and 2 respectively, then the bottom middle entries, so we have been given two values which are top left, that is 6. So this is our top left, that is 6. Second we have top right, that is 2. So this is our 2. Now what we need is the bottom middle entry, so we need this one. So let us begin. So as we know that the sum are same, so let's sum up all these numbers. So we have numbers from 1, 2 till 9 we have. So summing up, we will get our value to be 45, which is very easy. You can sum up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which comes to be 45. So for 45 to be equally divided in these three parts, columns, rows and two diagonals, we need to divide 45 by 3. So each one will have a value, that is 15, that is the sum of terms in each column, comma, each row and each diagonal. We have two diagonals, each diagonal will be equal to 45 by 3, which is equal to 50. So basically this is our sum of each of the rows, columns and the diagonals. So as you can see in our first row here, we have 6 and 2, that is 8. So subtracting 8 from 15, we are left with 7. Therefore this must be 7, and we know that this is the middlemost block, that is the second block in the second row, in the second column. So this is the centermost block, therefore it must have the centermost number from this range. We have a range from 1 to 9. So since this is the centermost box, and to maintain this sum of 50, we need the centermost number from this range, and the centermost number from this range is 5. As you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we have 6, 7, 8 and 9. So we have 4 digits both sides. Here we have 4 digits, here we have 4 digits. So the middlemost number is 5. So from this we can say that this block is filled up with 5. Now we know that the sum is 15. Therefore we will take this column, and here we have 7 plus 15 will be equal to 12. So we are left with 15 minus 12, which is equal to 3. So this is what we needed, that is the bottom middle entry, which is 3. Therefore our answer is 3. Now let's check the options. So option number A matches with our answer, hence option A is the correct answer to this question. So now let's move on to our next question, that is question number 68. So question 68 says, in a 10 kilometer race, A, B, C, each running at a uniform speed gets the gold, silver and bronze medals. Okay, so in this question we have a competition that is 10 kilometer race, and we have three different competitors, that is A, B and C, and they get gold, silver and bronze medals respectively. So if A beats B by 1 kilometer, B beats C by 1 kilometer, then how many meters does A beat C? So seeing this question, you must be thinking that here A is beating B by 1 kilometer and B is beating C by 1 kilometer. Therefore, A must beat C by 2 kilometers, which is equal to 2000 meters. But as you can check the options, we do not have 2000 meters in our option. Therefore, this theory is wrong. So we need to make a different theory and solve this sum here. So let us begin with our sum. So as you can see that we have been said A beats B by 1 kilometer. Therefore, if, okay, so when A completes 10 kilometers, that is the complete race, when A completes the race, B only completes 9 kilometers, because A is beating B by 1 kilometer. So when A will complete 10 kilometers, B completes only 9 kilometers. So this ratio of their speed will be, ratio of their speed will be 10 is to 9. And similarly, B beats C by 1 kilometer. So the ratio of their speed will also be 10 is to 9. So let us write this here. A is to B, and our B is to C will also be equal to 10 is to 9. Here we have B is to C. So as you can see here, our A is to B is equal to 10 is to 9. And our B is to C is also equal to 10 is to 9. Which can also, this can be written as 100 is to 90. And this can also be written as, we have multiplied 10 here. Here we have multiplied 10. Here we are going to multiply only 9 to make this common P part. So multiplying 9, we get 90 is to 81. So now the resultant ratio, that is A is to B is to C, will be equal to 100 is to 90 is to 81. So the ratio of the speeds of A is to C is 100 is to 81. So ratio of speed of A is to C is equal to 100 is to 81. So this is our ratio, 100 is to 81. Therefore, 10 kilometers will give us 10,000 meters. As we know, 10 kilometers is equal to 10 into 1000 meters will be equal to 10,000 meters. So here we have 100, so we will multiply this with again 100. So this will be 10,000 is to 81 multiplied by 100 is 8100. So when A will complete 10,000 meters, that is 100 kilometer, C will only complete 8100 meters, that is 8.1 kilometer. So A will beat C by, here we will subtract this, A is completing 10,000 meters and C is completing only 8100 meters. So A is beating C by 1900 meters. So this is the range by which A is beating C in the race. So our answer is 1900 meters. So let's check the options. So here option number B matches with our answer, hence option B is the correct answer to this question. So I will like to end this video here. You will find solutions to the further questions in our next videos.